We're back with game 2 and my internet died. I wanted to put the entire series in one video, but yeah, since my internet died, I'm gonna do another one now. So let's go to Majerna on the Kaleo. I'm pretty sure this is Bandit Hooper on Black Living side or Specs, and then he has a little bit of Volta in action with U-turn on Lando and probably AV McGeehan with Volt Switch. But yeah, Leechy is pretty common on Vino at the moment. I like that a lot. And Comp's team is just straight HO with Mega Gyarados, I assume, and actually not I assume, we have seen this team used before. It's like a Hazardly Drill, and I think the Grin is also Sesh with like Ice and Spikes. So yeah, he gets his rocks first and then he's just gonna spin after. He already knows that that this is lefties, right? So yeah, he doesn't have to fear Rocky Helmet here, he can just spam Rapid Spin. Black Oblivion doesn't beat Defog on much with this Lardy, because like this entire team is offensive on the other side, and like if he defogs on Gyarados or Mimikyu or Magenta, they all could set up and could be dangerous. Yeah, I think it's just AV Magenta. Even though it could be Z-move as well. But what I was thinking is that either the Kaleo or the Lardy Scarf, and the other one of the two is the Z-move user, the one that is not Scarf. So he goes Zaya and goes Gren. What? I think he... What? What did he predict? Oh, I think he expected the Lando to come out and he doubled into Greninja, yeah. So he expected that the Zaya got scattered in Majerna? I don't know. Was he bluffing like Bandit? I don't know. I think he's just gonna get a spike up now, right? With his Gren? Because his Gren can't do any damage to Majerna. I mean, he must have predicted the land, otherwise this play doesn't make any sense to me. But yeah, I'm on slow wife right now. Pretty annoying, I hope I'm not lagging. Like, when I started recording this game, I was like, why are they not picking a lead? But then I realized, oops, my net died. I'm gonna have to cut a little bit out in my other recording, because there was like a laggy screen where there was just team preview for like 1 or 2 minutes. Oh, it's T-Wave, so it's not AV, wow. So is it some berry, like Ayapapa berry or something like that? Or sugar berry? Both items are definitely options, yeah. I mean, Venusaur is just so annoying. How does he beat Venusaur at all? And I don't remember if this Gyarados has... I don't think this Gyarados has Ice Fang. I think it's like Taunt, Dragon Dance, Waterfall, Crunch. It might have Ice Fang, I don't really remember it. Okay, so he's gonna Fish Frost with Death Drop. Lichita is like really nice for Venusaur, because otherwise it only has Synthesis as recovery, and Synthesis runs out kind of fast. He's gonna Cynthia, obviously. This might be like a bulky... Is it bulky sub? That is nothing. Is that Bandit? If the Vino is bold and like near max defense, that might be Bandit damage. But I'm not... Like a living knowing that the Vino is really annoying for comp to kill, he's just gonna switch it out. Save his synthesis, because if he stays then he has to like waste a lot of synthesis. I assume that comp is gonna go into like Gyarados here and like predicted HP Ice. Yeah, Black Oblivion could U-turn here for sure. He could get his rocks back up as well. But yeah, that's the obvious Gyarados. So he's gonna U-turn on the DD. I don't think Scarf Lardy kills this. Draco does around. Like, if it's Mega, it definitely doesn't. Does it kill? I don't think it kills. Oh, yes, Scarf T-Wave. Oof. I mean, if he spams Dragon Dance, like. If he spams Dragon Dance often enough, he can sweep with this. If he never gets Parrot. It's definitely just gonna waterfall this, right? Because he doesn't want us to be alive. Because if this is alive, Black Oblivion can bring this back and then shuffle Intimidate. That's at least what I'm thinking here. He might have to DD again to outspeed Scarflady, but T-Wave got nerfed, so like, I'm not sure how many DDs he needs, so he's probably calculating that in his head, or like with a calculator. But yeah, Black Oblivion won game one, was a pretty cool game. So you guys can check that out, I'll upload it before this. We have a lot more series coming later. So you guys just goes for Crunch. I guess Crunch in case he went Latios on Waterfall, not sure. So I think the Latios still outspeeds. Yeah, Latios should still outspeed, but even though T-Wave got nerfed. I mean, if this has like Waterfall, Crunch, Taunt, Drain Dance, then Kelly should take a hit, right? Yeah, Kelly should take a hit. Oh, unless it's a minus defense Keld, but I think it's Z-Move Keld, you actually. So it shouldn't be minus defense. Minus defense is only on Scarf if they're on Stone Age. It's between Kelly and Venusaur here. See, I got interrupted. He finally goes into Venusaur here. This took a while. And he's just gonna go Giga Drain here. Yeah, this shouldn't have Ice Fang, right? Let me look at the team. I mean, the team is really annoyed by Venusaur, so it would make some sense if it had Ice Fang. Yeah, that I think is the option for sure. I don't know why I said it shouldn't have. But yeah, Venusaur, like, the way you call Comp is, like, Comp is taking his time here, so I'm pretty sure he doesn't have Ice Fang, right? Oh, he's calking it, but like, maybe he's debating whether he wants to go for just Crunch damage or for Waterfall flinch. But if he could, yeah, he definitely outspeeds this because of the yeah, Crunch doesn't kill for sure. That's obvious. It's a Mega Venusaur, right? It eats. Oh, it has Ice Fang. That did nothing, but he gets the flinch. But yeah, that bounced off. Yeah, I just mocked his chat. That's what you get for double T wave. Why are they thinking that Crunch would have killed? Exactly, they forgot about Mold Breaker. Like, this is one of the reasons why, like, Mega Gyarados is kind of cool. So he, wow, this is like really weird coverage. Crunch Ice Fang Earthquake. I mean, it's not weird, but like, like this, it's all good moves to have on Gyarados, but like, and back in Auras, we were, Earthquake was like to hit Rotom Wash. That's not a thing anymore. Like, no one uses Rotom Wash. Earthquake is probably to hit Magearna hard, and what else? It's like the the strongest hitting move that Gyarados gets versus Keldeo. So if you get a Keldeo weakened and you get two Dragon Dances up, you could kill that as well. Pretty, yep, pretty sure this is Z move. So this doesn't even kill, and they have the para. See, Megalodon is so bulky, dude. I mean, the para was about to happen, right? And he got a flinch on a Vino, and he didn't get para'd there before, so like... Like, you can't really complain that he got para'd there, because like, before he didn't get para'd ever. You can just play rough here, right? Yeah, this is the Secret Sword Taunt Command, probably with Hydro Vortex. It says pretty cool. I was just thinking that, but I didn't. I was like looking at the smoke just yet, so I didn't say it. So Shadow Sneak kills. Shadow Sneak should kill. It's not life on Mimikyu, okay? So it's Z move, I guess. Yeah, I don't know. It's a Zygarde, just like some berry. I mean, Keldeo dies to rocks, like... I don't think he's getting the chance to defog in this game, because... Yeah, like, he's just not getting the chance. If he defogs something, sets up and he's screwed. So, like, he had to take the Keldeo there. I think he bricked the SD, that's why he taunted. Yeah, obviously. Otherwise, why would you taunt? Does Hoopa's hyperspace go to rid of this guy's? And that's actually interesting to find out. I'm not sure. Yeah, and get this money out, asking if it goes through. Okay, it doesn't go. They all know it. Even my man Dennis knows. I don't know why I thought it would go through. I mean, it goes through sub, right? Yeah, Mob Breaker goes for sure. Goes through for sure. I knew that, but I just have never seen this come up. So, like, I didn't know 100%. So, you missed player of that sucks. Because he could have still kept his disguise intact, and then taunt ends now, and then he could have SD'd on the Majorna. And then he probably. Like, he just won. Not that he loses, that he can still win it, right? How healthy is this Majorna? Oh, it's para at 56. Okay, so I'm not sure if he wins this because his Majorna's para and his Grand Dice to rocks. So he does connect this time, and pretty sure Ladi can't kill this, so he has to go into Majorna here, yeah. There's the never ending nightmare. It's probably, yeah, this mon is so weak without life orb. But yeah, he wins with the Mimikyu. You can just Shadow Sneak the Ladi. And the Ladi can't lock itself into a move that kills everything. Okay, he got a crit, but it didn't matter. Like, the Ladi had to lock into like Psyshock, and Majorna eats that, and Zygarde eats that, and like he couldn't Draco obviously because it's a Mimikyu. And like Surf also wouldn't have done enough if he had that. And but like he was T-Wave, Draco, Psyshock, and then Defog, I assume? Not 100% sure. But yeah, we're gonna see a game 3. See you guys in the next video. My internet is pretty trash, so I'm gonna cut it again. like, yeah.